A new ceasefire deal in the Israel-Hamas war hanging in the balance. An Israeli newspaper said Israel boycotted talks in Cairo after Hamas rejected its demand for a complete list of names of hostages who are still alive. The Hamas delegation reportedly arrived in Cairo Sunday, but there were no signs of Israeli delegation. Before Israel walked away from the negotiating table, Sunday's talks were billed as the possible final hurdle before reaching a truce. The nearly five-month-old war broke out after Hamas fighters stormed Israeli towns, killing 1,200 and capturing over 200 hostages. Since then, Israeli forces have killed more than 30,000 Palestinians. Over in the U.S., Vice President Kamala Harris calls for an immediate ceasefire in Gaza. She also wants Israel to increase the flow of aid into the besieged enclave to ease what she called inhumane conditions and a humanitarian catastrophe among the Palestinian people. Her comments were among the sharpest yet by a senior leader of the U.S. government.
What we are seeing every day in Gaza is devastating. We have seen reports of families eating leaves or animal feed, women giving birth to malnourished babies with little or no medical care, and children dying from malnutrition and dehydration. As I have said many times, too many innocent Palestinians have been killed, and given the immense scale of suffering in Gaza, there must be an immediate ceasefire for at least the next 6 weeks, which is what is currently on the table. This will get the hostages out and get a significant amount of aid in. This would allow us to build something more enduring, to ensure Israel is secure, and to respect the right of the Palestinian people to dignity, freedom, and self-determination.
During her speech in Alabama to commemorate the 59th anniversary of Bloody Sunday, Harris also urged Hamas to accept this ceasefire deal. She also echoed Israel's position in the war, saying Hamas should be eliminated.
Hamas cannot control Gaza, and the threat Hamas poses to the people of Israel must be eliminated. Hamas is a brutal terrorist organization that has vowed to repeat October 7th again and again until Israel is annihilated. Hamas has shown no regard for innocent life, including for the people of Gaza, who have suffered under its rule for almost two decades. And Hamas still holds dozens of hostages for nearly 150 days now. Innocent men and women, including American citizens, who were brutally taken from their homes and from a concert. I will repeat, the threat of Hamas poses to the people of Israel must be eliminated and given.
The Biden administration is under mounting pressure to call for a truce in Gaza. Months before the election, the U.S. president is facing backlash from Democrats over his handling of the war. The European Union also ramping up pressure for a ceasefire deal in Gaza. The chairman of the bloc's subcommittee on human rights visited Egypt to check on warehouses storing aid for Gaza. Items rejected by Israel were also stored in the facilities, including medical devices, medicines, and tents. The EU calling for a truce to allow the entry of life-saving supplies into Gaza.
Ceasefire is the only way in our eyes, in our views, to do the most urgent thing now, to prevent thousands of people from being killed, innocent lives from being killed, and to provide for humanitarian aid, which is dearly needed. So that is what we bring in our messages. And what we got to know is, and that let me please underscore, that we are really, really grateful to the Egyptian people for their support in a situation of absolute tragedy, of absolute crisis.